So we come to Group A in Class 8, and a very tight group indeed. We'll go into that in just a minute. You may have just seen the standings. Everyone on 3 points, and it's Juliane Wolf, the world ranked number 4, up against Pan Menggui of China. This is our umpire. And well, everyone has 3 points. Keep an eye on the other two athletes. They're playing at the same time. To Pam Katsompu of France. And Zofia Arloy of Hungary. Both these players have played them. And the Thai and the French athlete, the French and the Hungarian athlete are playing each other. Everyone has 3 points. Top two go through, of course. 2 points for a win, one for a draw. So a win here and you'll go through. And the loser will have to accept their fate. So yeah, the top two in this group will go through. It's a very tight group. So the winner here will be guaranteed of going through. And then we'll have to see who wins the other match to see who the other person is. No need to worry about tie-breaking. It gets very complicated, talking about match ratios and game ratios, then point ratios, and then if it's all level still, decided by lot. The match ratio is the total number of matches won by the player divided by the total number of matches won by the opponent in the matches that are being considered. Rather them than me to work that out. And so it goes on through the games and the points. But the gist of it is that the top two go through. 2 points for a win, one for a loss, of course. And as we were saying, very tight in Group A. Group B is a three-player group, but this one is a four-player group. This is Juliane Wolf of Germany. A win and a loss for her. Had a bronze in the singles at the World Championship last time out. And this woman won a team gold at the 2014 World Championships in Beijing. Also an Asian Games gold, Games silver rather, in the singles, and a team gold. So both these players know what it's like to experience success, and both of them fairly young in terms of Paralympic table tennis. Wolf, 28, our Chinese opponent just 26 years of age. China not as dominant in the Paralympic table tennis arena as they are in the Olympic arena. Ready to go, the other table's up and running. We had a late finish the last game, so just getting ready. Cecilia Arine of Nigeria is our umpire. Here we go then, Class 8, Group A. Winner progresses, loser doesn't. It's as simple as that. Tentative start from these two athletes. First point on the board for Pan MENGYI. Oh yes, set up by the serve, return wasn't good enough. Awful lot of spin on that, kicked up and easy for Pan, two apiece. Advantage for the world number four from the Offenburg club. That's the woman from Shanghai. Lovely backhand, crisp and precise. Four apiece then in this first game. Data from the German, good serve. Again, able to deal with the swerving side spin on that serve. Oh, brilliant. It was not a bad shot from Wolf, but it came back with interest from Pan MENGYI. Obviously, mobility around the table, a little bit of an issue for her, but she got around that really well. And she's on level terms. Dig it out, couldn't get it in time. Oh yes, play the waiting game. Happy to play on the backhand and then just able to switch. Wasn't the best of shots from Wolf. And again, slapping that forehand. Well, she was behind by two. She's up by three now. Good comeback from the Chinese athlete. Oh, and now a chance to take this first game. She means business, doesn't she? And there it is. Excellent work from the Chinese athlete, who a little bit of a struggle in the beginning of the game, but soon sorted out her game and has played with aggression and precision and looked good for that first win of the first game. So, advantage Pan MENGYI of China, ranked number six, two places behind Juliane Wolf, but she played an increasingly confident game in that first game. Well, the forehand not working that time. Juliane Wolf just playing it out wide and Pan not getting the shot she would have wanted. A huge amount of spin on that shot from Wolf, but still foxed the Chinese. Good start, isn't it? Much better from the German. G'ing herself up in English. And it's long again from Pan. Looking a little bit under the pressure, the onslaught of the German. Well, this is excellent work from the 28-year-old. Been playing table tennis since she was 8 years of age and made a debut all the way back in 2009, so very experienced. Yeah. Well, she was struggling in that first game, but she's grown with confidence in the second. Maybe this a winner-take-all match, really. And MENGYI will take as long as she possibly can. And the towel wiped down. Well, she has an answer to everything at the moment. Some excellent shots from Pan. But goodness me, didn't Juliane Wolf throw everything right back at her. Oh, not this time. Got a little bit lucky with the net cord, but she'll take it. No. Well, you can't place it any better. You will acknowledge your good fortune to your opponent, but you take it every time. Nothing that Pan could do with that. Oh, that's better. No doubt about that one. Oh, she has raced through this second game. And 8 game points for the German. What can Pan do? You imagine the game's gone. She'll have a towel down is what she'll do. Just slow the game down again. That's long. And that was a very straightforward game for Juliane Wolf. German coming roaring back from defeating the first game to take the second. One apiece then in this Class 8 Group A match. So a game apiece in this very important match. Very tight in Group A. Everyone has 3 points with a win and a loss. And the question is, who in this match will win, take themselves up to 5 and make sure they go through to the knockout phases. Too much power from Pan. Coach likes it. Certainly does. Just sat up nicely, asked to be put away. And no time to react for the German. Come back. She's certainly fired up. Wolf has cerebral palsy. Has excelled in this sport. And we expected to add to that singles bronze at the World Championship. In 2014, got the team silver as well. And what could she do at her first Paralympics? Oh, that's a fabulous shot. Got around really quickly onto the forehand. Just rehearses the shot again. Didn't hit it as she would have liked. Once again, starting to pull away in this third game. That was a great recovery from Wolf, but it wasn't enough. Edda from Pan, back to just 2 points behind. Takes the edge. Well, it's not the first time she's found a slither of the table. Nothing you can do when that happens. Just got to accept it. Battle of the backhands goes the way of Pan. For thought for Pan, behind in this third game. And playing the ball long again, always likes to rehearse what perhaps she could have done better. And it's long again. So, 5 game points to make it 2-1 in favour of the German. After losing that first game, she's come roaring back. And that will do it. I wonder if she's got a broad smile. What a comeback. Last 2 games, conceded just the 7 points in both through both of them. And she's been playing some very good table tennis. She has the advantage in this match that, well, the winner takes all. So then, advantage to Juliane Wolf, the German, has won the last 2 games to make it 2-1. Can she take this match in 4? Good start. Touching another thing and went long. Excellent backhand, very crisp indeed. It's long. Once again, the little rehearsal of what she'd like to have done better. And timeout has been called, not surprisingly, as the lead stretches in this fourth game. So, after losing the first game, a storming comeback in the second, and pretty impressive in the third too. And she's just starting to pull away the German. She beat Sophia Arloy of Hungary 3-1, but then lost to the French woman, to Sonfu. Didn't win a game in that one. But a win here, and she's through to the knockout stages. It's long again, and that 4-point cushion starting to look good now for Juliane Wolf. Body language not great from Pam, but she'll keep fighting. We know that much about her, and that's better. Trying to go down the line, Wolf, and couldn't quite nail it. The speed of the bat through the ball. Patience from Pan. A little bit tentative from both those athletes. Back to just two behind now. Oh, gets lucky. Nothing you can do about that. Really cruel for Pan. Especially at this stage of the match. She'll be disappointed, Wolf, with that. 7-5. It's going to be tight, this one. Pulling it back, Pan MENGYI, and the timeout called by the German now. Not sure I'm going to say too much. It's just about disrupting the rhythm, reinforcing what your player is doing well, And she's just got a little bit tentative, I think, in the last couple of points, as she knows she's getting close to victory. Both these players have had their timeouts. And we're back to business. That's an excellent use of the table. First to the backhand, then to the forehand of Wolf, and we're seven each. But Wolf has two serves to try and reassert her lead. Oh, well, she defended well there. No wonder the ban is smiling. She did everything but win the point. Manipulated Wolf all around the table, but couldn't make that advantage count. Oh, it's long. It's long. Oh, this is going to be a tight one. The return wasn't good enough. And Pan had no hesitation in dispatching that one. And for the first time, she is ahead in this game. That's a great shot from Pan. And she has 2 points to take it to a fifth game. And it's long, and she's done it. Well, well, well. Wolf at one point was 4 points ahead in this fourth game, looking like she was cruising to victory. And what a comeback from the Chinese athlete. We go to a fifth and deciding game in this match. Juliane Wolf of Germany, just taking a bit of time out for a comfort break, and I think has changed her shirt as well. And it's accompanied by an official, of course, and the coach, and we are ready to get underway in this fifth and deciding game in this enthralling Class 8 Group A match. And Pan has forgotten the towel. There we are, safely in the bin. Oh, great turnaround from Wolf. Kept going with that backhand. Everything panned through at her. She came back for more. It's long, and the Chinese athlete edges into a 2-point lead. No more timeouts for the coaches, of course, have been used. That's better from Wolf. Really crisp shot into the body of Pan. Shot, got around it. Good rotation into the shot. Three apiece, two games apiece. Couldn't be tighter. As you can see, a lot of the other matches have already finished. This one going the distance. Again, and this time it's the German who inches into the lead. Serve. Really should be hitting the table come what may. There's another one to put it right though. That's a lot better. Maintains that 2-point cushion, edging perhaps towards victory, but we did see her have a 4-point lead evaporate in the previous game. She's got back that Christmas in her play that kind of deserted her at the end of the last game. Question is, will she become a little bit tentative as she heads towards the end of this game? I Oh, a bit unlucky there with the net cord. Point pull back for Pan Mingji, the Chinese athlete. It's long. Pan is staring elimination in the face here. A very tentative response return from Juliane Wolf. And she has the serve now, it's in her hands. And that's gone long, given her 3 match points. Well, can she convert here? Wolf to go through to the knockout stages. And she's done it. She has done it. Well, what a seesawing match this has been. And she prevailed in the end. Too much power from Juliane Wolf. Pan just sending it long. And she will prevail in Group A. Kankak Sunfu of France also going through in Group A. Excellent work. She is delighted. And there's confirmation.